Hi everyone. The purpose of this video is to explain the distinction between concentration and partial pressure and the importance of that distinction in the context of understanding gas transport in the lung. The first question might be, why do we need to talk about partial pressure at all? Why can't we just talk about concentration when we talk about gas movement? Well, it's not because there's no such thing as concentration of oxygen in your blood or carbon dioxide. There absolutely is a concentration of oxygen in the blood. But when you think about why do we care what something's concentration is, it's because we're using that information to predict which way a molecule will dissolve, which direction across a membrane, and also how fast. But actually, that information about the concentration of a molecule, if we're talking about a gas moving from a solution of air to water, or vice versa, a water-based solution like blood, concentration won't tell you correctly which way something will diffuse and how fast. And the reason for that is that gases have different solubilities in air than in water, and in particular, oxygen has a vastly lower solubility in a water-based solution than in air. So although we might think that if, for example, we had five times as much oxygen in our alveolus than in our pulmonary capillary, that the oxygen would move from the alveolus to the pulmonary capillary, that's incorrect. Actually, it would move in the other direction given that particular concentration difference. So we can't use concentration to correctly predict oxygen's behavior in this situation. But we need to be able to correctly predict oxygen's behavior. So we need another concept, and that concept is one of partial pressure. In order to understand partial pressure, you first want to think about it in the simplest context, which is, what if the gases were all just in air? So we're going to ignore blood for just a minute. Well, in air, partial pressure is a super easy concept. It's just literally the percentage of the total air that that gas makes up. So air is 79% nitrogen. So if you look at the total air pressure, which at sea level is 760 millimeters of mercury, well, 79% of that 760 is going to be nitrogen, so that comes out to about 600 millimeters of mercury of nitrogen. The rest of air is mostly oxygen, about 21%, so if you multiply that 21% times the 760, you get 159 millimeters of mercury. So that's oxygen's partial pressure in air at sea level, 159 millimeters of mercury. Carbon dioxide makes up very little of air relative to these other two gases. Okay, so that's what partial pressure is in air. What is it in a solution, a fluid like blood? Well, it's very weird. This definition is very weird. The partial pressure of a gas in solution is the partial pressure of that gas in an air mixture or a gas mixture with which that liquid is in equilibrium. So, in other words, if you have oxygen, if you had a cup of water that was half full, and you had oxygen in the air and oxygen in the water, and you let those come to equilibrium, then the partial pressure of the oxygen in the water would be the partial pressure of the oxygen in the air. But, so, by definition, that amount. But the actual concentration of oxygen in that air and water solution would not be remotely the same. Let me give you an example. All right, so here's this container. All right, so initially, let's say there's no oxygen in this water here. Okay, so here's the water, initially no oxygen in there. You put a bunch of oxygen in the air above that water and you let the oxygen dissolve. All right, naively, we might assume that we're going to end up with the same amount of oxygen in the water as in the air. And that would be true if oxygen were equally soluble in air and water. But in fact, oxygen is vastly more soluble in air than in water. So once you let it come completely to equilibrium, you have far more oxygen in the air than in the water. Actually, this cartoon actually exaggerates the amount of oxygen that went into the water. So you can see partial pressure of oxygen is 100 millimeters of mercury in these two solutions, but the concentration is much greater in the air than in the water. Because of this solubility difference, we have to use partial pressure because we can use partial pressure to correctly predict how oxygen is going to move between these two solutions. But we can't use concentration. If we just look at the concentrations here, it looks like we would expect more oxygen to go into solution. But here we are at equilibrium. The partial pressures have equalized, but the concentrations are not the same. That's why we have to use partial pressure, because it's the thing that's really going to tell us in which direction and how fast will oxygen move. The upshot of this whole thing is, wow, look, oxygen really won't go into solution in your blood. And yet, you're using up tons of oxygen every second just to stay alive. So there has to be a solution to this problem, right? That we need a lot of oxygen to get into our blood, but oxygen doesn't really want to come in by itself. It has such low solubility that you're not going to get much movement of oxygen into the blood. So we know who the hero is here, right? It's hemoglobin. So hemoglobin is this molecule, and the way it works is that once this a little bit of oxygen will come into your blood, right? Because there's some solubility of oxygen in there. And then hemoglobin binds it, and when it binds it, it removes it from solution. See this arrow going here? So if one molecule came in and was bound by hemoglobin, well, look, now there's no oxygen in solution anymore. So now we're maintaining that partial pressure gradient, which pulls oxygen in. And if as the oxygen comes in the cell, it's bound up by hemoglobin, you're maintaining a low partial pressure of oxygen in the blood, and that continues to draw oxygen in from the air. Having hemoglobin in our blood allows the blood to contain between 80 and 90 times as much oxygen as it would without hemoglobin. So hemoglobin is absolutely essential to getting enough oxygen into the blood for us to stay alive. All right, I hope that makes sense, and just let me know if you have some questions.